Scenes from G2e, Global Gaming Expo 2016. The expo is huge. I'm just showing the section where the slot manufacturers feature their new games. I will have some videos of these games to share on my channel. But remember that many of these new games are not completed yet, nor do they necessarily reflect the pay tables they will be installed within the casinos.
Okay, guys. Here's G2e, Global Gaming Expo at the Sands Convention Center, which is a Venetian, basically. There's the IG2 booth. Just came from there. I tried the Betty White game. It was cute. Goonies. Goonies is really good. I really like Goonies a lot. Jurassic World, 3D, brilliant. Really great graphics. Dinosaur really came out and startled you. They have the boys here, they have Sphinx 4D, new Ghostbusters, all sorts of new games by IG2. I think IG2's back with some better games, more fun. Aruzi? Who knows? Okay, I give up. Aruzi. That has some promise. These tower stack games seem to be highly featured here and look to be a little fun. This is one of the tower stack games of this pirate theme. Touch and slide. What's down this way? Touch and slide. I was told the Ultimate Eruption was a really fun game. I should probably try it. We're not really supposed to be recording the games here except Aristocrat gave us permission. IGT didn't seem to care. I wish that was for real. Okay. Vegas is around here. Walk with me. I did play the Huckleberry Finn and the Gulliver's Travel games briefly. They were cute. Very cute. It's probably an Ainsworth game I would try. This World of Sports over here, I participated in one of their little tournaments. Got a t-shirt. It was fun. It's currently not in tournament mode though. It had a feature where during your wins in the tournament, you could keep doubling down. So if you got a great win, you could double down and get ahead of everybody briefly. Or if you picked the wrong one for the double down, then of course you lose your money for that win. But it was interesting because you had a little choice to make during the tournament instead of just brainlessly hitting the button. Konami games. As you know, I don't play a lot of Konami games. Crowd has tons of fun new games. I got some videos of those. That lady is dressed up in a Sharknado outfit. Sharknado is a big game here in the Aristocrat booth. I played it. You'll see a video of it. It's funny. Never saw the movies, but it's a funny stunt game. And Hasselhoff is in the Baywatch game they have, too. He's making it big in the slot room these days. There's a new game I found that looked interesting. I didn't get to play it. It's really packed. I might try to go up now and play it. Try not to get dizzy as I'm walking. Elvira, of course, doesn't like Elvira. I did think the pays were a little lower than they could be.
Calm down, lady. Just needs to make a phone call.
Yeah, there's no way I'm going to get to Game of Thrones side. But I actually like the new Game of Thrones. It doesn't have the big, huge tower screen. And some of the games looked really interesting. Tim McGraw is a big game here at G2e for Aristocrat. I'm not a fan of his, but people tell me who are fans of his, they really like this game. And we got a man.
You sure know how to strike a chord. Friend Boots like the new Michael Jackson icon game. Some people really like the Godfather game, so that might be worth looking at. There's Seinfeld. Seinfeld is quite funny. We've got a slot in The Bachelor. I don't watch the show, so I didn't care about it. Chevy Chase and the guys, Griswold Family, Vacation, really funny. Really enjoyed that one. Simpsons, love the Simpsons. Can't wait till Simpsons comes out next year.
like old movies, which I do, Humphrey Bogart. They had Stephen Bogart here briefly signing and taking photos of people. That's Lauren Bacall and Humphrey Bogart's son. Lori has Richie Rich, Underdog, Casper. They used to be multimedia. I really like their new game on Penn and Teller. It's really funny. It really captures the spirit of Penn and Teller. For any of you who are fans of those two guys, it's a great game. Very funny. They seem decent. Also, Avari Multimedia has a new tournament. I participated in it briefly, and instead of just popping balloons these days, the balloons can go into an explosion where you have to constantly just slap your hand on the screen and try to get as many as you can during the tournament. It can go into its own popping explosion where it explodes on your screen. Adds an extra interest to the multimedia casino games that so many casinos are using for their daily tournaments. So 8 bonuses in Penn and Teller. And we are definitely at the end of our tour now. I'm at the end where I walk out, and this closes down G2e for 2016.